Today, we are going to talk about our ceramic coating. Comes out pretty clean.
He struggles.
He does. It's early. Yep.
It's too early for this.
It's not that early, guys. It's like 8. It's like 8:10.
8:20.
8:20.
Yep.
Well, our goal is to leave at 9. We're on track.
Yep.
We just have a little bit more to do.
Okay, so we're leaving Hershey.
Yes.
We've been here 3 weeks now.
So we've been at Hershey Thousand Trails, or Thousand Trails Hershey. I don't know which way they say it. It was an unexpected surprise because we weren't supposed to be here for 3 weeks.
Right. But we decided to stay an extra week.
We did. And it was actually nice not having to travel.
I agree.
A lot cheaper on fuel.
Mm-hmm.
Did not have to travel.
So. Yeah. Where are we going?
We are going to Lake George Escape in New York to visit the Inquist.
Yeah.
Which are... our friends and Nick's buddies are all there. And Michaela's buddies are all there. So the kids get to hang out with their friends for a week before we head to Vermont.
Cool. Vermont, then Maine. Then I think we're going back home before we make our way down to Florida. And
we haven't announced it yet.
I know. We're going to have
We have some news, guys.
We're going to have to talk about why we're going back to Florida in the middle of summertime.
Yeah, we'll do that later, not on travel day.
All right.
Because she's not prepared.
Not doing it.
Not doing what?
not camera ready.
She's the reason we're going to Florida.
You're not supposed to tell people yet.
I know.
All right, if y'all want to like a behind the scenes of what's going on, like this is what we deal with all the time.
Y'all want to know why the kids are never on camera?
Yeah, they're always behind me making noises or faces or whatever. But yeah, that's what we deal with.
Check it out. Look how easy that is. I don't have to worry about storing that cord somewhere anymore and moving the router every time.
So something else I wanted to tell you guys about is on travel day, what we do is you see those big old inverters over there, courtesy of Battleborn. Those inverters get turned to inverter on. So while we're parked on 50 amp, I put them on charge only, unless we're having power issues, and then they'll go inverter on. That way they toggle on if something happens. But I just changed those to inverter on, and that means we have juice from these Game Changer 3.0s right here, all the way down the road. So yeah, that system has come out so handy. Absolutely love it. If you're thinking about upgrading your system, make sure to check out Battleborn, because those things are amazing. All right, we just made it to Lake George Escape.
Yes, we are in New York.
New York, and we're meeting some friends here. It was a long day, almost 400 miles.
Oh, it was so much traffic.
Lots of traffic, great New York roads. Just the kind of normal thing, yeah?
Yeah, so we just got here. This is the area that you stop at to check in. Mm-hmm. And you go over to the lodge mm-hmm. and check in. So we're gonna go over there and see Sarah and Jeremy.
Yep.
And then they're gonna show us our site.
And yeah, so we got to check in. Long day. Get some dinner.
Let's go. No.
Yes.
Hey there.
Hi. I'm on TV.
So not necessarily the nicest site, but it's a site. We're home. I think it's Memorial Day weekend, first of all, so it's really busy. And we kind of did a late check. We got this site late, so you know, we can't be too picky. It's a corner lot. Mosquitoes are out like crazy already. We're just gonna unhook if people leave Sunday or Monday, because I'm actually off on Monday for Memorial Day, then we'll move the rig. But as of right now, good enough. Today we are going to talk about our ceramic coating.
It's such a hot topic. Everybody wants to know, how do we keep our rig looking so clean?
Yep, it has been over a year since we had this thing ceramic coated.
Yep.
And you see how shiny it is still?
And that's look, dirty.
And I'm sorry, Matt, we haven't washed it in months. And we haven't had time to do it. And the truck is looking...
Well, in our defense, it not only have we not had time, but we've also been in 3 different RV parks that do not allow you to wash
your rig. Yeah, that's always a challenge.
So that's the challenging part. So we go months without washing it when we can't wash it.
But the truck, we can take to a car wash and things like that, but we can't always find a place to wash the dually. But here we have. So what we want to do is I'm going to walk you around, and you can see how dirty it is and see how dirty the truck is.
Yes.
And then what we figured we would do is not just talk about the ceramic coating, although we have absolutely loved it. We could show you.
Yeah, we want to show you what it's like to wash it.
Well, just how clean it will come.
And what it looks like afterwards.
Because it looks like it's brand new. I had somebody stop me in the parking lot and ask me if that was a brand new truck.
Yeah, so the way that it looks right now is through 2 different campgrounds that are full of dust.
Yep.
So when the people ride around in their golf carts, like, dust is just flying everywhere. And then we went through 2 different pollen seasons because we were coming north. So pollen has been setting on it. So now if you look at our truck from afar, it looks maroon. If you look at the truck from the inside, looking out the windshield, it looks green.
It's not maroon right now.
It's not maroon.
It's like brown. But so let me just show you what the truck looks like right now. You can't even tell what color it is when you look out of the windshield. Okay, if you haven't seen our other video on when we got the rig ceramic coated, make sure you go check that out now. Big thank you to Bob Moses Ceramic Coating out in Phoenix, Arizona. Really all of the locations, they do amazing work. We follow them all on Facebook. They do just a great job. So big shout out to those guys. Now, a little bit about the ceramic coating is they use Sensha, which is a Japanese-based product. And it has an 8-year warranty on it. So it should last a long time if you're taking the proper, like doing the proper maintenance and things like that on it. So we're in Lake George Escape, Thousand Trails, and well, it's an Encore.
Yes.
And we came on the 2 busiest weekends of the year. So we're out washing the truck instead of exploring because it's getting kind of crazy around here. But yeah, we hope it will come pretty clean, and you guys can kind of see the process and see the difference, the before and after of what this thing looks like.
So we have a filter system from Amazon that we use when we wash the rig at home. When we come to car washes, we try to find the ones that have the spotless rinse cycle, because it's the same water going through the spotless rinse. So I don't know if this car wash has that yet or not, because we haven't been here to find out. But it's so bad that at this point, I don't care. I just want it clean.
Definitely needs to be clean.
So let's get started.
Well, we have to use the lamb's wool
yes.
cloth. can't just use like a regular.
Well, you're supposed to put the sensor in a spray gun and spray it on, and then let it like runs off, and then you don't really have to scrub it. But when we come to car washes, we use a lamb's wool because we can't connect that spray gun to the end of their system.
Right.
But we literally are only using the booth for two reasons. One, it's in the shade so it can cool the truck down, and two, it has a rinse feature on a jet hose. The rest of it we do by hand. We don't use any of the brushes or any of the nozzles here at the car wash or any of the soaps here at the car wash. We literally are just using it for their water source and a bay.
Mm-hmm.
So,
all right,
let's get going.
So I have my handy dandy lamb's wool. I have a pole that extends so that we can get the roof, and then we dry it off with microfiber. But this bay actually has air that you can use too to dry it off. I'm sure it costs extra, but you know. And we will be using our Cintia power foam, and we don't have a foamer, so we're just gonna use a handy dandy brush. But we're gonna spray it off, get all this dirt off first. But everybody asks us, like, how does ceramic coating hold up to like full-time RV living? I mean, it's dirty, but it's still shiny. That's the thing. And it'll be pretty shiny when we're done with it too. And it doesn't have any of those swirl marks like most paint does. So it's pretty awesome. As long as you only use this type, do not use a regular brush on it or those swirls will come on back. But yeah, so we're gonna get started and we're going to start washing. Let's go. So we used our ceramic coat soap and wiped it on with our lamb's wool, and now we're just rinsing it off, and then you dry it with a microfiber. Preferably you would dry it with air, but we dry it with microfiber, and yeah, it's coming out pretty clean, so pretty nice. There's no real downside to it, but it is a little bit higher maintenance to maintain. I will say that, because like Cindy was saying, you got to use the RO water. You're supposed to use like the spotless water, and then you can't use just normal like chemicals or normal soap or wax or anything like that on it. Of course, you shouldn't need wax, but you can't just use any soap because it can actually strip some of the ceramic on it. So that is kind of like a con to having the vehicle ceramic coated, but I will say the pros vastly outweigh. All right, a year later, comes out pretty clean. And it is bright and hot out here. But it comes out pretty clean for it to be a year later. Now, this isn't the best job that I've ever done, that's for sure, but we're rushed and I think it's filthy. It could use like three more baths.
Yes.
And a nice coating of the spray would be pretty helpful at this point. But
yeah,
it's super shiny still. You can, all the metallic's coming out. There's no brush mark still. But it's definitely, being on the road is taking its toll.
Yes.
On the truck. Ceramic coat is holding up pretty good so far. You ready?
I am.
All right, let's go get some dinner. So do you think ceramic coating is worth it as a full-time RVer?
Absolutely.
Yeah, after a year, like, it has definitely held up to the abuse that full-time RVing has on a RV and a truck.
If you were full-time RVing, you would have to wax it like every quarter. So we do not have to do that.
Right.
And the washing process is super simple. It just takes time and the appropriate environment, I guess, because you don't want to wash it when it's super hot out and stuff like that. So it's a little challenging for being a full-time RV because we don't have a home to actually like wash it and not worry about the water, since all the campgrounds don't allow you to wash your rig or even your truck,
right?
Because of water runoff and water consumption and all of those things.
That
part can be challenging.
I would definitely recommend it. Like, we intentionally left out prices and things like that. It's been over a year since we got our stuff ceramic coated. If you would like an estimate, reach out to Bob Moses Ceramic Coating directly. We have the number and all of the information down below. They can help you with an estimate based on your given situation.
Right. Every camper is different. Every paint job is different.
Every
vehicle is different. So, like, even us versus our friends that have the exact same rig, the price could be different just because of the amount of paint correction or the amount of clear that's on it or anything like that. So there's so many different variables. They really need to talk to you about your rig.
No. Well, you can actually submit right on their website too.
Oh yeah, that's right. You can do that also.
Yep.
But they're all really nice guys, and every location is just phenomenal. So don't be afraid to reach out.
Yeah. All right, there you have it. Ceramic coating is worth it still after a year. So we would definitely do it again.
Oh, absolutely.
So if you're thinking about investing a lot of money into a truck or a rig or something like that, ceramic coating is worth it. Obviously, resale value, things like that, it's going to help out in the long run.
It makes it look good longer.
Yes, it does. All right, well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you really like it, make sure you subscribe.
Ring the bell so you know if I release our next video.
Until the next strange adventure.
Keep making your own.